Hi dear friends, myself Deepak More, and today I am going to teach you mathematics of 7th standard. Though the first lesson is integers. The topic which one I am going to teach you, the name of the topic is division of integers. As you know that the multiplication of integers, same the division also have the rules and properties. So we will see one by one. So the division also have the two rules. The first one rule is division of an integer of same sign is always positive. Means what? If suppose that we have integers and if that integer having the same sign, then answer of the division will get that will be always positive. We will see it theoretically. So that is one integer upon another integer of same sign equals to a positive integer. Means one integer, it will be divided by the another integer. Both the integers having the same sign, if both the integers having the same sign, then the answer whatever we will get, always it will be positive. So here there are two types. The type first is where an integers, both the integers are positive. Positive integer divided by positive integer, the answer we will get, that is a positive integer. And here negative integer upon negative integer, the answer we will get, that is nothing but a positive integer. Okay, means positive integer divided by positive integer is always positive, and negative integer divided by negative integer is always positive integer. For example, suppose that we have a equal to 8 and b equal to 2. So by using this formula, 8 by 2 means positive integer divided by positive integer, the answer we got a positive integer 4. Now for this, a equal to minus 12 and b equal to minus 6, then this is same. So the formula is negative integer divided by negative integer, the answer is positive integer. We will write negative 12 divided by negative 6. This negative will get cancelled, and 6 to the 12. That is why the positive integer divided by positive integer is always positive, and the negative integer divided by negative integer is always positive. Hence, the property that says that division of an integer of the same sign, always the answer we will get, that is a positive integer. Now we will turn to the next rule. The rule number second is as division of an integer of different or opposite sign either is always negative. Theoretically, that is one integer upon another integer of different sign, then the answer will be, or it will be always a negative integer. Division of an integer of a different or opposite signs, the answer whatever we will get, it will be always negative integer. Here also there are two types. The types are negative integer upon positive integer is equal to a negative integer. It is nothing but a positive integer upon a negative integer. The answer of this also a negative integer. So we'll see the examples. Examples are, suppose that a equal to negative 6 and b equal to positive 3. By using this formula, negative 6 divided by positive 3, the negative sign is as it is and 3 2s are 10. The answer we got a negative integer. And for this formula, suppose that the example is a equals to 15 and b equal to negative 5. Then by using this formula, 15 by negative 5 equals to negative sign is as it is and 5 3s are 15. And from these both the examples, you can able to understand the rules. And hence, we prove the rules. Now, the next topic of the lesson is properties of division of integers. The topic name is properties of division. In that, the first property is, if m and n are two integers, then the division of that, means m divided by n, is not necessary and integer. It means that if m and n are the two integers, and if the division of that both, means m divided by n, is not necessary, that the division will be an integer only. For example, suppose that m equal to 50 and n equal to 8. Then the Bayes formula, m divided by n, by putting the values of m and n, 15 divided by 8, and it is not divisible. We cannot able to divide 15 by 8. Always, it is not necessary that the division will give answer as an integer. Okay, so the first property is proved. Now we will turn to the next property. The next property is, as if m is non-zero integer, then the division of m to itself is always 1. If m is a non-zero integer, then the division of m to itself is always 1. For example, if suppose that we have value m equal to 15, then the division of m divided by m means what? 15 divided by 15. So 15 ones are 15 is always 1. Okay. So property also we proved. Now the next property is, for every non-zero integer m, m divided by 1 is equal to 1. For every non-zero integer m divided by 1 equals to m.
Means that
any integer divided by 1 is always that integer.
For example, suppose that we have m equal to 26. Then m divided by 1 equals to 26 divided by 1. So the answer will get 26. If on the place of positive 26, if there will be a negative 26, it means that m equal to negative 26. That will be same. M divided by 1 equal to negative 26 divided by 1 equal to negative 26.
Means the integer, it will be positive or negative. Whatever the answer will get, that will be always that same integer only.
Now the next property is, for every non-zero integer, m, 0 divided by m is equal to 0. It means that for an ending integer, if 0 is as the dividend place and the integer is at a divisor place, then whatever the answer will get, that will be always 0. For example, suppose that m equal to we have 20, then 0 divided by 20 is equal to 0. We will turn to the next property, property number 5. So it is as, for every integer m, m divided by 0 is not meaningful or not defined. Means for an every integer m, m divided by 0 is up to now it is not defined. For example, if m equal to 8, then m divided by 0 means 8 divided by 0 is not defined or it is not meaningful. Now we will turn to the next property, that is property number 6. The property number 6 is as, if L, M and N are non-zero integers, then the division of them is L divided by M in the bracket divided by N is not equal to L divided by in the bracket M divided by N, unless L equal to M equal to N equal to 1. So we can able to prove it. First of all, we will prove for this. If we put L or M or N equal to 1, otherwise on the place of L, M, N as a 1, then the LHS of equation is L divided by M divided by N. It is equal to 1 divided by 1 divided by 1. So 1 divided by 1 is 1 and this divided by 1 is as it is. And 1 divided by 1 is 1 only. Now we will go to the RHS. So RHS of the equation is L divided by M divided by N. So it will be 1 divided by 1 divided by 1. First of all, we will solve the bracket. So 1 is as it is. 1 divided by 1 is 1. So 1 divided by 1 is again 1. So the LHS is equal to RHS. That is why this property is true only for L equal to M equal to N equal to 1. Otherwise, any one value equal to 1. Now, this is not true for other values rather than 0 and 1. We will see the example for that. So the example will be as, If L equal to 8, M equal to 4, and N equal to 2, then the LHS of the equation is L divided by M divided by N. By putting the values in the LHS, 8 divided by 4 divided by 2. So we will solve first of all the bracket. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So 2 divided by 2, this divided by 2 is as it is. So 2 by 2 is 1. 2 ones are 2. Now the RHS of the equation is it is equal to LN divided by M divided by N. By putting the values in this, H divided by 4 divided by 2. First of all, we will solve the bracket. So, 8 divided by will be as it is, and 2 2s are 4. Now, 2 4s are 8. So, LHS equal to 1 and RHS equal to 4. So, that is why the LHS is not equal to RHS, and hence the property is true. Now the next property and the last property of the division of integer is as if L, M and N are integers, then the case first is L is greater than M and N is positive. Then the division will be L divided by N is greater than M divided by N. It means that the division of L divided by N will be greater than M divided by N. For example, if suppose that we took the values of L equal to 8, M equal to 4 and N equal to 2. Simple values. So by putting the values in this same, L divided by N is greater than M divided by N. We have to prove this. So by putting the values in each, L divided by N means L equal to 8 divided by 2. Greater sign is as it is. We are proving it for that. 4 divided by 2. So 8 divided by 2 is 4 and it is greater than 2 to the 4. Hence the property is true. Means 4 is greater than 2 and hence the property is true.
Now the second case is as given on the board. The case is as L is greater than M and N is negative. Then L divided by N is less than M divided by N. For example, we took L equal to 8, M equal to 4 and N equal to negative 2 as they told. So by using the formula L divided by N is less than M divided by N, and hence by putting the values of L, M and N, 8 divided by negative 2 is less than 4 divided by negative 2. So 2 4s are 8, the negative sign is as it is, that is why negative 4 less than sign is as it is, because we have to prove it. And 2 2s are 4 and the negative 2 have the negative sign, that is why the negative sign is as it is. So as we know that negative 4 is less than negative 2 and negative 2 is bigger than negative 4, and hence the case second is true.